While I'm telling you guys this story, I'm having my teriyaki shrimp noodles. You see it? Oh, it fell on my bed. Oh my gosh. I've actually posted this recipe before on my YouTube channel, so you just have to scroll down to like one of the first few videos that I make, and it's on there. Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you don't know who I am, my name is Giselle. And today, as you can see by the title, I'm going to be telling you the story of how one of my clients almost fainted on me during a session. Now, yes, I was having my teriyaki shrimp noodles. I'm on my last bite right now. It was so good. I couldn't wait. Like, I'm hungry. Ooh, do you guys like my shirt? For those of you who watch The Office, and comment your favorite character from The Office, because mine, as you can see, is Dwight. Before we continue with this video, please make sure to like and subscribe to my channel. That way you don't miss out on any videos. I post fitness and lifestyle content to show you how I am able to maintain a healthy and sustainable lifestyle. So this particular incident, whatever, happened like, I want to say in May, I think around May or April. So at that time, I had actually two sisters. So they signed up for partner training with me. And this happened like kind of in the beginning of their, you know, whole training, like program, I guess. It was definitely like a month or less in, and they both wanted to basically bulk. They both wanted to put on some muscle mass, especially in their lower bodies. So it was a beautiful Monday morning, and I remember their session was at 9 a.m. It was their first leg day of the week, not ever, but it was their first leg day of the week. So, you know, they came in and, you know, they're starting to warm up and talking to them. You know, I like to talk to my clients, of course, like, hey, how are you guys? You know, how was the weekend and blah, blah, blah. And I do want to emphasize that I usually ask my clients like, hey, how's the eating been? How's it been the past few days? Or because they were just starting and they wanted to bulk, they were kind of having a hard time getting all their meals in, and their bodies are just so used to that. So it can be a little hard, like changing that habit and going from one meal to three meals. But I always gave them tips on, you know, how to go about that and how to do it properly without it feeling so stressful and overwhelming. But again, they were just starting out, so I can understand that, you know, it takes time. So I had asked them like, hey, did you guys eat breakfast by any chance? And they actually said that they didn't eat breakfast. But to me, that wasn't a red flag or anything like that, because to be honest, like I said, they were just starting out. So there were times where they would eat breakfast, there were times where they wouldn't. So they were still a little inconsistent with that. So I remember the first exercise was squats. So they did that. It was fine. Second one was hip thrusts. I'm gonna just say Sister A and Sister B. Sister A, you know, was doing the hip thrusts and, you know, she was doing fine. Sister B, she was also doing them and, you know, they both seemed fine. They were both fine. So I was like, okay, you know, and then once they were done with that, we were moving on to leg extensions. So Sister A was like, hey, can I go get some water? And of course I was like, yeah, yeah, like, go ahead, you know? And then Sister B was also like, hey, I'm also gonna get some water. And I was like, yeah, like, go ahead and go for it. So I'm just, you know, like wiping down the machines for them. So I'm wiping down the hip thrust machine and, you know, setting the weight for the leg extension machine, you know, just kind of like chilling there, not thinking anything. And then all of a sudden Sister B comes back to me. She like walks to me. She's like, hey, my sister's not feeling well, which is Sister A. And I was like, oh, okay. But in my head, again, I'm not thinking anything crazy. I'm just like, okay, you know, like, I don't know, she's not feeling well. You know, I probably will just end the workout for her. So then I am like, okay, like, let me go talk to her. So I walk towards Sister A. You guys, tell me why her face is pale. And as soon as I saw her face, I was like, uh-oh. Like, literally in my head, I was like, and then she was like, oh, Giselle, I don't feel well. I feel dizzy. Her eyes even started like kind of going back a little bit. I was like, no, no, don't close your eyes. Don't faint on me, right? And I have actually fainted before, so I know what it feels like to faint. And it's a sucky feeling. But yeah, in my head, like, I am like starting to freak out. But on the outside, like, I'm super calm. You know, I'm chill. Like, I'm the personal trainer. So if I freak out, then they freak out. And it's just a whole thing. So it's like, no. Like, so on the inside, I'm freaking out. I was like low-key mentally preparing myself for CPR. In order to be a trainer, you have to be CPR certified anyway. So I have that. But like, still, it's just like, You know, I've never done it in real life before, so like that's crazy. Have you guys seen the game plan? It's the scene where the little girl, Peyton, right? So she's allergic to nuts and she has like some dessert thing or whatever, and she's at the restaurant with her dad, the ballet teacher. And there's that scene where she's allergic to nuts and she didn't know that the dessert had nuts and she ate it. And you know, like she can't breathe. And The Rock, who is playing her dad, throws her over his shoulder and starts running to the ER. That was literally me in my head, you guys.
Hospital, where's the nearest hospital?
Nine in Woodrow. Look in the car. Where are you going? What are you doing?
Move!
Literally in my head, I was running to the hospital with her. But like I said, on the outside, I'm just calm. I'm like, okay, like let's go ahead and go to the turf and I'm gonna have you lie down, right? So that way, you know, the oxygen or her blood, or I think it's for like the oxygen to like go to her brain, right? So I'm just like, okay, I wanna lie her down. Ooh, I also forgot to mention this. So you guys are probably thinking, okay, Giselle, how much were you pushing them throughout the workout? I am being very honest, you guys, because they had like just started, like it wasn't anything crazy. It was not intense. And don't get me wrong, I don't want to say the weight wasn't like heavy, because heavy is different for everyone, but I would say it definitely was not heavy. I know when people can do more weight, it was like moderate, honestly, light to moderate. So I'm like holding her hand, you know, as like we're going, you know, walking slow, and I also elevate her feet, that way it like does it a little bit faster. So, you know, she's lying down. I'm just like, okay, how are you feeling right now? She's like, you know, still the same a little bit, but I'm sure I'll feel better. Like, I just need to like lay here for a few minutes. I was like, of course, like no worries. And you know, and then Sister B is like with us the whole time, by the way. So like we like just stopped the workout. And I actually went to the vending machine to get a cookie, and it's like protein like stuff. So it was like the what is it? The Lenny's cookies or whatever, the protein cookies. Y'all know what I'm talking about. That brand. Well, you know, I saw a chocolate chip cookie in there. I was like, okay, let me go ahead and get that. And I gave that to her. I was like, here, eat this. Again, I'm not a doctor, so I don't know, but usually when someone faints, they say to like give them something like kind of sugary, that way it like spikes their blood pressure or something. Again, I'm not a doctor, so I don't know. Don't quote me on that, okay? So I'm asking Sister A questions, and I'm asking like, hey, so, you know, were you feeling weird before you came here? I'm just trying to get a better understanding, because I want to make sure, okay, was it really my workout that did it? Was I really pushing too hard, or could it be something else? And then Sister B actually is like, hey, you know what? I think I know why my sister is not feeling well. And I was like, oh, why? She said, oh, I don't think my sister has ate for like a long time. And then I look at Sister A, and again, she's still, you know, lying down. And I'm like, hey, when was the last time you ate anything? Tell me why. Like, look, by the way, like, I hope, I don't know if they're like watching this. Like, by the way, you guys, if you guys are watching this, I don't know. I'm not bashing you in any way. I'm just kind of, you know, telling the story for entertaining purposes. But it's not bashing in any way. But I am being honest, like, what I'm about to say kind of shocked me a little bit. So, you know, I asked Sister A, like, hey, when was the last time you ate? Tell me why. She said, oh, the last time I ate was yesterday, which was Sunday at the time, 3 p.m. or something like that. I was like,
what? What? Hold up. Oh, hold up. Wait a minute. Wow.
3 p.m.? 3 p.m.? From 3 p.m. all the way till the next day, 9 a.m.? That's more than 12 hours of not eating, like nothing. She was like, no, like I didn't feel hungry. And I was like, oh girl, that's why you almost fainted on me. Like, I thought I was like pushing you too much. No, it's because of that. So yeah, I mean, honestly, after, you know, talking to her and everything, I came to the conclusion that it was because she didn't eat for that long, which makes perfect sense, because, you know, again, like I said, it was really not that heavy, and it really wasn't that hard on either of them. Like, it was light to moderate. It wasn't anything crazy. But it was also a wake-up call for her. Like, hey, you know, maybe start eating before you come here. And again, you know, I understand, like, sometimes people just want to sleep in and get as much sleep as they can. At least, you know, a banana, some crackers. I mean, something with carbs, you know, to give you that energy. And on top of that, this was a lesson for me. And this was something that I got to experience. Sorry, I'm like looking because the Amazon driver's delivering my package. He's cute. Okay, anyways. The good thing is I'm glad like I have had my experiences with fainting before. So I pretty much like know how to like handle that type of situation. I think I was just freaking out a little bit in my head because it wasn't really necessarily like the fainting. I guess it was just more like, okay, there's like a bunch of people. By the way, it was busy that morning too. The gym was packed. So everybody and their mama was in there, like, so it was just like, I think it was just more like that, like, oh my gosh, like, there's so many people here, like, you know, and I'm the trainer, like, I have to like make sure I know what I'm doing. Like, it was just more like that, kind of like the responsibility of it. I think that is kind of what scared me, and I was like, I always, you know, try my best to read, you know, body language correctly. But remember, guys, do not go more than 12 hours without eating before a workout. Please don't do that to yourself. Have your carbs, okay? Carbs are fuel. Carbs are energy. It's good for you. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this story time. So please go ahead and like, comment, share, subscribe, turn on those post notifications so you get notified on your phone every time I upload a brand new video. Stop. Before you go, I want to remind you guys, I totally forgot to update you on my Marvel movie marathon. So right now I am actually on Captain America the Winter Soldier. Yo, Captain America Winter Soldier is one of the top Marvel movies. It is so good, like the fight scenes and like, bro. Good. And on top of that, you know, it's Captain America, you know. No, but like, I love Iron Man too though. So the first one you guys saw in my Unwind with Me video, if you haven't seen it, go ahead and check it out. But I posted, I was talking about how I was starting it and it was Captain America the First Avenger. That was the first one. And then after that, Captain Marvel. Honestly, I skipped it. It was my first time watching it. 40 minutes in, bro, I was like, yo, this isn't it. So I skipped it. And then after that, it was Iron Man. Iron Man 2. Love Iron Man movies. The Incredible Hulk. My first time seeing it, I actually really liked it. I thought it was great. I wish there were more Hulk movies. Thor. Thor is pretty fun too. So Thor was good. The Avengers. Love the Avengers. And the Dark World. Iron Man 3. And then Winter Soldier, which I am on right now. And then after the Winter Soldier, I have to watch Guardians of the Galaxy. So yeah, you guys, just to update you on my Marvel movie marathon so that way y'all know what's up. Alright guys, but I'm pretty much done here, so stay tuned for my next video. Bye!